From around the globe, it's theCUBE with digital coverage of VMworld 2020. Brought to you by VMware and its ecosystem partners.
Okay, welcome back everyone to theCUBE's coverage of VMworld 2020 virtual. I'm John Furrier with Dave Vellante, a student man who's covering VMworld virtually from our CUBE virtual studios where we've been doing theCUBE coverage for the past 6 months virtually. Guys, let's wrap up VMworld virtual this year. Different, not in person, still packed with content. Again, they tried to replicate and they did a good job of bringing that site together. They didn't overdrive the platform. They have content, but still a big gap in not having it in person. A lot of action on Twitter, certainly. We've been commenting on the cube.net site and getting all these videos out. But guys, let's wrap up VMworld this year. Great show. Again, content's virtual, so a lot of asynchronous content. The Cloud City, a lot of solution demos, the CUBE commentary on our side. But Dave, what's your reaction to the past few days?
Well, I thought, you know, as always, VMware has some highlight folks show up to their keynotes. John Donahoe, who knows a little bit about the enterprise because he did a couple of years stint at ServiceNow, then he jumped back to his consumer roots, went to Nike. Interestingly, ServiceNow, the company he left, they're approaching $100 billion valuation now. They're zoning in on Nike, of course, and then you had the NVIDIA CEO. Everybody does business with NVIDIA, and so that's kind of a checkbox, but to actually get the CEO to come to your event, I think is a big deal. So as always, people want to do business with VMware because they get 500,000 customers, and I thought that was pretty impressive gets.
And the CEO from NVIDIA, Jensen, was on. I mean, you couldn't ask for a timely guest because of the news with them buying ARM. And just NVIDIA just as a key player in the chip game this right now.
Yeah, and I think too, you know, some of the announcements VMware made around Edge and even telco, NVIDIA is going to be huge there in ARM. You know, we think that is going to be a really new and interesting AI inferencing at the edge. There were some AI announcements, so very strategic. Again, you know, VMware does a great job of identifying those waves and driving engineering to drive customer value.
Stu, I want to get your take on the announcements, and Dave, you can chime in too, because obviously we saw the Snowflake IPO. To me, this basically rings the bell for the worldwide global computer industry around cloud native. This to me puts the full stake in the ground, cloud native. VMware's made some bets, Stu. We go back and look at Gelsinger's moves and Sanjay's move and the team's moves. Your thoughts on the announcements? They had networking, a lot of multi-cloud, but it's all about operational cloud native. Your thoughts?
Yeah, well, John, cloud's so important. You know, let me make an analogy here. We all talked about if this pandemic had happened 10 or 15 years ago and we were stuck at home without our Netflix, without our Zoom, without our connectivity, where would we be? John, when we started coming to the VMworld show in 2010, it was a huge amount of gear sitting in Moscone and the amount of trucks that needed to deliver all of that. Of course, today it's all built in the cloud. So doing those labs are so much easier. And learning and enabling these technologies can be done so much easier. So I think that really puts a highlight on where we are with the technology. And you know that was one of the key things that we saw in that announcement. So where VMware fits with the big hypercloud players, how they're helping to extend what they have in a hybrid environment from a management standpoint, starting to push out to edge solutions. VMware has strong strength with service providers. So there's a lot of things there to dig into and that we wouldn't have had if we were talking about this 5 years ago.
I just love the glam of the NVIDIA because the AI angle there is super important. But I love the Project Monterey, Stu, because it kind of digs out VMware trying to set the agenda on architecture. This is the end-to-end. You know, whether it's the edge of the network from a work perspective person, even in space, the purpose-built devices at the edge still need to be updated by software. This is a huge architectural shift. Do you think VMware's got the right moves here?
Well, John, VMware's got some great strength in the service provider environment, and of course, you know, great strength in data center. They've been growing their cloud capabilities. So edge is still a little bit of a jump ball, as we like to say. Absolutely like some of the things that they're doing. Strong partnerships. We talked about NVIDIA. Absolutely one of the companies you want to be closely working to be successful at the edge. So I like what I'm seeing. But as with anything with VMware, until they have thousands of customers doing it, it's still a little bit early for me to have any final say.
Stu, 30 seconds left. Tanzu, portfolio and partnerships.
Yeah. So the critique I'd have, John, is VMware has been trying for years to go deeper with developers, and they've made some progress, but they haven't done enough. They're doing more with open source. They've made a number of acquisitions in this space, but it's all about developers. It's about building those apps. If you talk about a hybrid message, you know, Microsoft, nothing about but building new apps. VMware is starting to get there, but they still have work to do.
Guys, great job. 2020 is in the books. The Cube is here virtually. And again, 10 years ago, John Troyer, Eric Nielsen, Robin Matlock was our partners. Now we're going to the next generation with VMware next 10 years. Unpredictable. We'll see how it goes. Thanks for joining us today. Appreciate it. Okay, thanks everyone for watching Cube coverage of VMworld 2020. I'm John Furrier with Stu Miniman and Dave Vellante. Thanks for watching.